I'm Helen Butler, the Youth Information Coordinator with Youth for Ireland and Galway, based here in Ballinasloe. And I coordinate the European Solidarity Corps and European Volunteering Opportunities. I'm joined this evening by Megan and Michael, both of whom have availed of the opportunity to go abroad in the past and want to share their stories with us. So thanks, guys, very much. So to kick off, Michael, I think you went away the first. So where did you go? When did you go?
So I went over to Georgia on the 14th of September in 2015. And I went over there for a year in the voluntary service in a youth centre. I was based in Rustavi, which is about 30 minutes from the capital, BC.
And tell me, was that your first time to go abroad on a trip like this?
No, I actually done a short-term EDS project in Finland, Kokkola. I was there for a month.
And did doing the short one before the long one help?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, definitely. It definitely transitioned me into the long one. The long version of the voluntary service. Because I guess it kind of gave me a sense of independence.
Okay.
And in some way, I built up resilience. So I felt stronger going into a long term voluntary service.
Thanks, Michael. And Megan, where did you go? And when did you go?
Yeah, so I went in 2018 for about 2 months to Albania, and then 2019 I went for 10 months to Finland. So like Michael, I started off with a short-term one, kind of get used to the independence and get a bit of confidence in traveling alone before I committed to a big one.
And was that a useful feature of the voluntary service for you being able to do the project?
Oh, definitely. I don't think I would have committed to the long-term one first, because I'd never traveled alone, so it's like a practice run.
Okay, great. And what prompted you to go? I'll just go back and over some. What prompted you to go in the first place?
Well, I guess I just kind of wanted to get out of Ireland and just see what the world is like. You know, I had to come back hopefully with a different perception of my own life as well, not myself, kind of reestablish myself. Because I think for quite a while, I kind of didn't really know what direction I wanted to head off in. So I think for the voluntary service kind of put me in the right track and way, which is mostly work with people.
Okay. So was it the thing of you had to go out so you could look back in to see what life was like in Ireland, so that when you came back, you could be different?
Yeah, basically, kind of getting out of the environment where I kind of was living up to the expectations or the perceptions or how I was perceived by other people.
Okay.
And for me to go out abroad, it was me to truly understand myself without having the influence of others on me. So basically, I could, kind of get a deeper understanding, know who I am as an individual rather than playing off other elements.
And Megan, was it something similar for you, or was it a different thing entirely?
Yeah, to be honest, it was kind of similar. I had just finished up secondary school and I had no clue what to do with my life. I didn't know what I wanted to do, if I wanted to go to college or what. And then towards the end of secondary school, you actually came to the library here and we came to talk and you were talking about it. And it's just something that piqued my interest. And I was like, oh, give it a shot, see how it goes.
I remember that, actually.
Yeah.
I remember you contacting me afterwards, which was great. And just, I suppose, for people who are watching, European Voluntary Service, this whole notion of volunteering abroad can be for a period of up to 12 months, but you can do a short version of up to 8 weeks and then follow on with a 10-month in a different country or a different area if you wanted to as well. So it gives you a chance to have a little taster as well as having the longer one, rather than running the risk of going abroad for a long period and feeling like maybe I won't be able to do this. There is that possibility, which is kind of useful. When you look back, Megan, at your time, what stands out for you from that time? Were there high points, were there low points?
Oh, there was, of course. In Finland particularly, because when I first went over, no more than that, you're going on your own. For me, that was a big change. And it was for a long period of time. And so where I went in Finland, it was quite an isolated area, so it took me a while to get used to that. So at first, I was afraid to go on my own, and it was a scary new thing. So that was kind of a low point. But eventually, like, you're with other volunteers there, you're meeting people from different countries, and it ended up being the best thing I've ever done. I've met so many who came from who I still keep in contact today. And I've had so many experiences about it that I'd never regret it.
Did you get homesick?
I did, yeah. When I went first to Albania, I did, because it was so different over there, but it was constant going. It was in Finland, I was longer there. Some things were similar, but I really missed home a lot. Because you're away from your family, your friends, so.
And what helped? Was there anything particular that you did or anything that helped with that homesick?
For me, I think a big thing that helped was the fact that when you're there, you are doing like work, you're a few days a week, you're with kids. Well, what I was doing, I was working on kids, and that really helped me because it kept me active, kept me going, and kept my mind on something else. And then eventually, as you get used to facing people, you don't feel as homesick anymore, really.
Great, great. And Michael, did you feel homesick? Georgia is very different to Ireland.
Yeah, I did, yeah. I was homesick in the early stages of it. I remember getting off the plane and into the airport. We were getting swarmed by about 30 taxi drivers and taxi. And then I remember getting into the taxi that was actually ordered for me. I remember driving down this motorway that wasn't finished yet. But I remember each side there was lads selling watermelons, where it was about this big, like, huge. And the heat and everything was just so different compared to Ireland. And you know, there was no thing about saying, I got there, it was just like, you know, over here, just floating around a bit. And when I arrived, there was only one other volunteer, so I was waiting for the other volunteers to come. But I remember even waking up the next morning, being dehydrated, falling outside the bed, and just feeling disorientated, and like, oh my God.
Questioning your wisdom.
Yeah. But it's character, you know, really does it.
So then, the structure of volunteering abroad is that you have an organisation like Youth Work Ireland involving that works as a sending organisation. So we would have supported both of you from here and also while you were there. And then over in the countries in Finland and Georgia, you have hosting organisations who made the application for a volunteer. So their job was looking after both of you. You know, how was that, two different organisations liaising with you, working with you, that work?
No, for me it worked. As you know, sure, I was in constant contact with you, and it was nice to have someone at home to talk to and talk back to. And obviously, I was never worried about family or anything. I knew you were there, all that. But then it was nice having someone in the country with you, because obviously it's nice to have someone in front of you to go to if anything went wrong.
Of course.
You had a fallback.
Yeah, yeah. And what about you, Michael?
The sending organization, you've heard about it. Very good. Constantly in contact with me. If I had any issues, they always felt like they were open to hear me out. So there is the support. My hosting organization, they were good, like, but I think they were giving mentoring awards to people that just didn't have time to be mentors. So that kind of lacked in that sense. But in a way, it kind of worked out that the volunteers kind of like, work with each other. There's more solidarity amongst you.
Okay, so you got
together
and strength.
Support each other.
The others. Yeah. Okay.
That's how ours work more or less. Yeah.
And there is scope within volunteering for extra supports as well for somebody who's never traveled or who feels really worries about whether or not they'd be able to. So there's scope actually for the hosting organization to have extra supports in place as well. You guys didn't need them, but you know, it is there for people who might feel, don't know about this.
Yeah.
When you look back now, I mean, it's longer for you than it is for you, Megan, but nonetheless, it's still, we've had COVID since you came back.
Yeah.
What's different about you because of your time in Georgia?
It's actually funny in a way, because I travel quite a bit, and especially my time spent in Georgia. I would still say. I definitely say that, you know, I'm Irish in that, but I also feel like that kind of built this kind of self-image of being kind of like more or less part of the world. You know, I'm not just like, I'm Irish in that, more like I have kind of more of a worldview about things now. I feel like I have more knowledge about different cultures, more culturally aware in Georgia, I kind of embrace the culture and I find out different things. But I would say that more open-minded and definitely more understanding of different cultures. I'm not afraid to jump in and embrace the food, but music or whichever.
Very interesting. So, what about you?
Yeah, you do kind of realize that as well when you go to places. There's really this community about Europe being like, as a European country, it's not just, I feel like in Ireland, it's less so. It's more, we're Irish, where you go to other countries, it's really, they embrace other cultures a lot more. And that's a great thing to see and great thing to be part of. And it's kind of great to bring it back here as well. Like, that's lovely.
Would you consider you're different because of your trip to England?
I would, yeah. I think no more than that kind of opens up your mind a bit, but also like you get a whole different worldview of it and you kind of keep that with you and build your confidence a lot. Like I'm a lot more confident since I came back than I was when I left. I'm a lot more confident to do new things, try new things. Just something I never would have done before I left.
And what about your families? Would they have said anything about how different you are?
I know my mother anyway, she's definitely said a few times, she said the best thing you ever did was leave, because when you came back here, you've just changed. You can't not change if you do something like that.
And what about your family, Mike?
I've often been told by my cousins I'm not just an Irish traveler now, I'm an international traveler.
Very good.
I'm probably more than any of my cousins. But I guess my family, my mother has been very supportive, but they all always like to hear my stories when I come back. I remember I brought my first trip with somebody, I bought a cigarette box back from my mother and all. So I'm very happy with that trip. But things like that, like, I often used to bring back a lot of different things, but then over time I just stopped bringing back things and just started bringing back stories.
So just to kind of pull it together and wrap up, would anything you'd like to say to young people who might be thinking, I'd like to do this, but I don't think I can do this. Should I do this? Will I do this? Would I be able for it?
Well, I think if you're like uncertain, it's a good thing to like make the first step, try and get involved in something. I get involved with your organization, the Nova Youth Center, and that. And then slowly, if you want, do the EVS. Do a few weeks away, see how it goes. And then, if you like it, you can do a longer term. It's always about making that first step.
Great one. Mike, what would you say to your, I suppose, younger people in your life?
I'd say, if you're not content or you're not happy in what things are doing, maybe, like, I know youth organizations, there is a great support for young people, you know, even through like the council and youth information center and groups like Living in the Corner and all. But I'd also say, like, you know, like European Orange Service or European Solidarity Corps. I guess the thing about that is, like, if you're not really too happy with what's going on in your life at the moment, at least there's always that opportunity for 18 to 30 years go out and re-establish themselves, maybe get to know themselves and even get to know a bit more of the world. And I think that would definitely make a difference in the university because they're not just going over offering something to where they're going, but they're also bringing back something as well. Maybe something that would change their life for the better. So no, it's definitely changed my life for the better.
Fantastic. That's really, really good. Thank you both so much. I think there's so much in the European volunteering, there are so many opportunities. All you've got to do is contact your local youth service, give us a shout or wherever you are, if you're local, on a shout, and we get you started on that path. And how far you go and what you do is always your choice. So thanks very much.